Pancreas. Sounds familiar, doesn't it? What does it do? Did you know that the treatment of pancreatic cancer is more challenging than other cancer types? But why is that? Let's learn about pancreas and pancreatic cancer. You can think of pancreas as a hidden organ because it sits behind some other organs. It is part of our digestive system. So let's take a look at our digestive system. This is our stomach. Below our stomach, there's our liver. Right under the liver, there's the gallbladder and its bile duct. With a front view, if we look below, we will see large intestine and the small intestine below. Well, where's the pancreas? As I've mentioned, it hides behind some organs. Did you notice something yellow behind the large intestine? This is pancreas. It's a jelly-like soft gland which is connected with the bile duct that comes down from the liver. Its head touches the duodenum and its tail touches the spleen. It has two main functions. They are exocrine and endocrine functions. The exocrine functions produce digestive enzymes that help break down food like fat, protein, and carbohydrates. And these enzymes are excreted into the duodenum, which is the first duct that comes down from the stomach. The endocrine function regulates sugar level of our body, releasing hormones like insulin, glucagon, and somatostatin. Okay, let's understand exocrine and endocrine glands better. Exocrine glands release their secretions into ducts. Endocrine glands release their secretions into blood vessels, which means the secretions directly get mixed with blood. Endocrine glands release hormones, but exocrine glands do not release hormones. Try to remember the exocrine with the word exit. For example, salivary gland. The saliva exits into a duct. So the pancreas is a gland that makes both hormones and enzymes, but only 2% of it makes hormones, and the 98% of it makes digestive enzymes. Also, the 2% of pancreatic cancer is neuroendocrine pancreatic cancer, which is related to the hormone function, and 90% of it is exocrine pancreatic cancer, which is related to the function that makes digestive enzymes. That's why when pancreatic cancer is mentioned, the exocrine pancreatic cancer comes to mind. Another name for it is adenocarcinoma. Unfortunately, 5-year life expectancy of pancreatic cancer is 10%. To find out why, we must first learn what cancer is. Cancer is a name given for a group of illnesses caused by the accumulation of damages in the DNAs of cells. There are over 150 types of cancer, and with the subgroups of these types, this number can go all the way up to 1,000. Normally, cells make copies of themselves and multiply. Also, if there is a damage in their DNA, they fix it, and if they can't fix it, they destroy themselves. If the damages in the DNA are beyond repair, and if the cell can't destroy itself, it turns into a cancer cell. Cancer cells multiply and spread uncontrollably and unpredictably. They can enter blood vessels and lymphatic nodes and spread out to different parts of body, such as the brain, lungs, liver, and bones. This spreading is called metastasis. If the cancer is spread from its originated point, in other words, if it's metastasized, it's called advanced stage cancer. When a patient is diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, it's generally metastasized and in an advanced stage because the pancreas hides behind some organs and its symptoms are quite similar to other illnesses. It is mostly diagnosed late. The most important symptoms for pancreatic cancer are jaundice, stomach and backache, sudden weight loss, lightness in color of stool, darkness in color of urine, nausea and loss of appetite, newly detected diabetes. Well, do these symptoms mean that you have pancreatic cancer? These symptoms could be caused by other illnesses as well. So if you have any symptoms, do not neglect your health and talk to your doctor. Pancreatic cancer is not very common and it is quite hard to detect in an early stage. Also, the immunotherapies that are quite effective in some cancer types have not shown any meaningful progress in pancreatic cancer. But of course, there can be exceptions. So the treatment options are limited. However, do not think of it as a completely hopeless disease. Lots of research is being done on the treatment of pancreatic cancer. For example, in December 2019, the first targeted therapy for pancreatic cancer was approved by FDA. Also, the improvements on chemotherapy treatments seem quite hopeful. Let's check out the treatment options with details. In pancreatic cancer, the treatment option is determined according to the spread of the tumor and the stage of cancer. After the diagnosis, it is considered if it's metastasized. If yes, then it's in an advanced stage. If no, then it's in an early stage. In the advanced stage, our main goal is to control the spread of the illness and to prolong the lifespan. In the early stage, our main goal is to shrink the size of the tumor, make it available for the surgery, and to get rid of the illness. Because the only curative treatment in pancreatic cancer is surgery. If a patient is diagnosed in an early stage, it is important to know if they are available for surgery. And here it is divided into two groups. Resectable or operable, which means the patient can have surgery. And potentially operable, which means the patient cannot have surgery at the time but might have in the future. In the operable group, the first plan is to start with neoadjuvant chemotherapy, which means before surgery, in order to get rid of micrometastasis that is not visible, to lower the risk of relapsing and make the tumor more available for surgery. After about 2 or 3 months of chemotherapy, pancreatic surgery is done, and after the surgery, the remaining treatment is completed to a total of 6 months. In the potentially operable group, the compulsory pancreatic surgery is not considered right away, because the pancreas is very close to the main arteries and even small growth can infiltrate these veins. In this group, neoadjuvant chemotherapy named FOLFIRINOX is given to patients. And then after 2 or 3 months of chemotherapy, imaging and re-evaluation is done by a multidisciplinary team of professionals and decided if the patient is available for operation. If yes, then pancreatic surgery is done. And after the surgery, the remaining treatment is completed to a total of 6 months. If the patient is considered to be unavailable for surgery after the tumor shrinking chemotherapy, then systemic therapies are carried on. And if the patient cannot tolerate the treatment, then gemcitabine plus nab-paclitaxel is also one of the effective and preferred chemotherapies. Also, to these patients, radiotherapy can also be applied if seen fit. In the advanced stage, there are groups called locally advanced and metastasized. In these groups, the tumor has most likely spread into the lymphatic nodes around the pancreas. And on the fourth stage, patients are mostly detected with liver metastasis. These patients will receive chemotherapy in order to shrink the size of tumor, to control the spread, and most importantly, to extend life expectancy. The main treatment applied to these patients is also a chemotherapy regimen called FOLFIRINOX. So there's 4-drug chemotherapy regimen called FOLFIRINOX, used in advanced stage and early stage. It is used to prepare the patients for surgery in the early stage, and to extend the lifespan and to improve the quality of life in the advanced stage. This chemotherapy regimen is a proven therapy that has taken place in all of the oncology practice in the last 5 years. To be able to administer this regimen to a patient, he or she should be in a good condition, having no other serious illnesses. If the patients who are receiving this treatment show continuous response for minimum 16 weeks, then they are recommended to have a genetic test called BRCA. If the BRCA is positive, the patient can receive a targeted drug called olaparib. If the test is negative, then the FOLFIRINOX regimen is carried on. If the patient is not able to tolerate this therapy, or if there is a progression in the illness, then other tests are done to find out if the patient can receive immunotherapy or a targeted therapy. If one of the genetic tests is positive, then suitable immunotherapy or targeted therapy is considered. If these tests are negative, then gemcitabine-based chemotherapy is applied. As you see, the pancreatic cancer is not a completely hopeless disease. We shouldn't neglect our health, and we should always be in contact with our doctor. To find out more about the treatments of pancreatic cancer, visit drozdoğan.com. Let's create a conscious society that is not afraid of cancer.